Magnify the Lord with me. Magnify the Lord. Jesus alone is worthy. Magnify Him.
Hello. Welcome to Magnify Him. My name is Lyndon Carriger.
And I'm Danita Jones. And once again, it is our honor to present to you artists who have come to bring their gifts and lift up the name of Jesus Christ.
And yet the focus is never on the gift. It is on the gift giver. So stay tuned as we lift up the name of Jesus, our soon coming King.
Magnify the Lord with me.
Today on Magnify Him, we have instrumentalists with us. We have a pianist by the name of Jason Thomas and a cellist by the name of Michael Bent. Welcome, fellas, to Magnify Him.
Thank you.
Real quick, where are you from?
We're from New York.
New York, what part?
Queens.
Queens.
I'm from Queens.
You're from Queens?
Yes. Well, I mean, I was born in Brooklyn. I lived in Queens, but we both go to Elmont Temple, Elmont Long Island, New York. Yeah, that's where we're from.
Okay. Now, Jason, you're the pianist, correct?
Yes.
So, when did you start playing the piano?
Well, the story, it actually starts from when I was 5. I wanted to play since I was 5. I begged my parents, but they said you wouldn't practice because your older brother didn't. So finally, when I reached age 14, they was like, okay, go ahead. And from that point, I just kept going and practicing a lot.
And you mentioned practice. How long do you have to practice in order to...
So when I was in high school, that was when I practiced the most. I mean, I started playing in 9th grade, but getting towards 12th grade, especially in the summer times, 8 hours a day, usually. I averaged about 6 hours a day, and yeah, six
That's
to eight,
a lot.
Yes.
That's a lot, and I'm sure it shows. Yeah. You do this professionally?
Yes, actually, I graduated from this school called Manhattan School of Music.
Okay.
I got my bachelor's degree in classical piano performance and master's degree, and I'm trying to get my doctorate degree by God's grace. Please keep me in prayer for that.
I definitely will.
Yes, and I've also done competitions. I performed in Finland. I won a competition there, and just a lot of performances everywhere.
Well, praise the Lord. Yeah. I'm going to go to your partner in crime. Now, you have a group name. What's the group name?
Strings in Harmony.
Strings in Harmony.
With the letter N.
With the N, the letter N, correct. Harmony, yeah. What made you guys come up with that name?
Well, we had a hard time trying to figure out what we'd call ourselves. You know, we went from MJ, from the first initial of our names, to JM, maybe PB&J, I don't know. But Strings in Harmony, I'm the strings. Well, Jason's the strings as well. The strings are inside the piano, so we're both strings. And the harmony, that can come with... Any other instrument we may include. I also play the saxophone and I also sing, so maybe we could, you know, blend those talents together in future projects. You know, strings and harmony, it all ties in together.
Okay, what made you choose the cello over the sax, or do you play any other instruments other than the cello?
Yeah, the saxophone and I sing. The cello, I just love the sound. It's unique. It's soothing.
Mm-hmm.
It's
big.
Yeah. It's, you know, it's just a lot. It's just a lot to say. I just love the sound. When I'm playing it, just, you know, I'm trying to focus on it like I'm in another place, you know?
Yeah, I personally love the cello sound. It's very soothing. What age did you actually start playing?
I started at age 9. And I was in 4th grade. All I can remember, I just remember my teacher's name, Mr. Klimchek, and we started in an orchestra. It's just a lot of fun. Just mm-hmm. a lot of fun playing in an orchestra. After that, I moved on to Southern in Tennessee, and I just continued playing cello there. And now I'm here back in New York with working on The Gift with Jason. Doing concerts and the AY programs at different churches.
Now, I heard how long Jason had to practice with the piano. Is it the exact same with the cello? Is it more or less? Or
it's a lot of practice. I try to fit in time to practice. Yeah, it's definitely a challenge.
Oh, I mean, you have to practice because you guys have a CD.
Yeah.
Strings in Harmony. It is called The Gift. Everybody, you guys have to go out and get it. They're making their debut here on Magnify Him. Tell me a little bit about this CD.
Well, actually, and to also add to that, I want to add how we started as a group, too, because
okay.
they go hand in hand. We go to the same church in Elmont, and I came to him one day. I noticed he played cello, and I said, hey, Mike, would you like to make a CD together? He was like, sure, let's do it. All right, let's get a lot of arrangements of different hymns. And so this CD, it has 10 arrangements of gospel songs and hymns that we came up with together. And we started on it, this project, last year in August. We practiced, we played some songs for some performances. I'm also a piano teacher. So one recital, I invited Mike to come along. And the rest is history. If we fast forward to like last month is actually when we finished with this project. And a friend of ours says he has a free hall for us to go to. And he says, can you have everything ready by, you know, a couple of weeks? And we just rushed to the recording studio and got it done. But I love this.
Real quick,
project.
I want to ask both of you, for the young viewers that may be watching, do you have any advice for them as musicians?
I'd say trust God. Try to find out what His will is for your life. I'm still going through that right now. You know, just praying a lot, trying to find where my place is in God's ministry, you know.
Praise the Lord. Real quick, you can give your shout out. You got like 5 seconds.
Okay, I'd like to give a shout out to this camera. I would like to give a shout out to Elmont Temple, Linden SDA, my wife Camille, and all of my friends.
Okay, everybody. We have Jason and Michael.
Thank you.
When we get to heaven, Jesus will crown us with crowns, but we will crown him with many crowns.
We are always so excited when we can have people on our program that can sing their testimonies to God. Today is no different. I'm excited to have in the studio Miss Tessa Greenaway. Welcome, Tessa.
Thank you.
Now, I'm excited that you're here. One of the reasons is because you came to us from quite a distance. Tell everyone where you are from.
I'm from St. Thomas, U.S. Virgin Islands.
Wow, and that is an incredible place, I know, to grow up and be raised. One of the other great stories that you and I were talking about earlier is how you got started singing. Could you tell us a little bit about that?
I started singing at the age of 4 years old, on stage, not necessarily. Before that, I started singing, but my mom put me up on stage to sing one of my favorite songs from the hymnal, number 86, How Great Thou Art, at a tent revival meeting on the island of Montserrat, where she was born and grew up.
Wow, and that is a huge song for a four-year-old to sing on stage for the first time. But I know it had to go over really, really well. And that was something great happened 20 years later. You were telling me about you being able to sing that song when you were four. And then when you turned 24, you were able to, go ahead.
Yes, I was able to sing that song again at a tent revival meeting again.
That is great. And so you're saying that your mom just put you on stage and said, you know, sing. Does your mother sing, or have you had a chance to, anybody else in your family sing?
My mother is the first singer I've ever heard.
Wow.
And she sings, my father sings, and Everyone in our family sings, but not necessarily on stage, my mother and I.
Wow, so you've had an opportunity to sing with your mother.
Yes.
I know that has to be an incredible thing to hear. That's awesome. So let's talk a little bit about your ministry. You tell me that you have been traveling on the island and you sing in a lot of churches. What are some of your favorite songs to sing and minister with?
Right now, a lot of people are requesting and have requested this song called Blessings by Laura Story.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a song that she wrote right after her husband died of cancer.
Mm.
And it has blessed a lot of people. In fact, because it's called Blessings, I thought that was great.
That's an incredible thing, and be able to use someone else's testimony in order to minister. What is some of your other favorite songs to sing? I know you said How Great Thou Art and Blessings. Is there another favorite that you have?
I love to sing songs like We Shall Behold Him, songs like Grace, songs like Amazing Grace,
mm-hmm.
songs like It Is Well With My Soul. I just love those songs, songs with messages with deep penetrating meaning to it.
And that's always important. So you definitely look for the lyrics and the meaning
right.
behind. That is an incredible
thing. They
have
to affect me if they're going to affect anyone else.
Absolutely. And we encourage all singers that are ministering to be able to do that. It kind of has to speak to you.
Yeah.
Talk about some of the what the songs that you're singing today and what those mean.
One song that I'm singing today is In Brokenness You Shine. And it, to me, even though it was written by somebody else, it felt as if it was written for me,
mm-hmm.
because I feel like right now I'm broken, I'm shattered, and how can God use me like that? In fact, that's when he does his best work, and that's when he shines the brightest. You know, so I love that song because of that, and it's a prayer song, a prayer to God to ask him to use you. Even if you're broken, even if you don't know where else to go.
And we can't wait. And ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor to present to you Miss Tessa Greenaway.
Trust you. this world of trouble, Jesus wants us to be light bearers of peace, love, joy, and hope.
Never was the world in such a need of peace, and never has contentment been so hard to find. So many men reaching out their hands, our brothers and sisters in so many lands. If ever kindness was needed, then it's crying out to us, the time.
You know, Lyndon, I always love closing the show with a song.
Well, Danita, we have a piano here.
We do, don't we? Go ahead and try it.
Always remember Jesus.
Next time as we magnify him.